Praise the Lord. Well, thank you, Pastor, and my sister for such a wonderful, what is that called? Introduction. Thank you. Totally went out of my mind, you know. That's a good thing about being black. You don't blush. Praise the Lord. Some of you all are starting to lighten up a little bit. Praise the Lord. But thank you so much. I love you all so very much. And, you know, one of the reasons I came to check on Pastor is that we had corresponded some through texting and talking a little bit. And one thing I know, people can tell you one thing on the phone through a text and something else totally be going on. And so I needed to put my eyes, they big, I needed to put my eyes on him to see, you know, that what he's telling me was true. And when I got here and just saw how well that you were doing and how much on the other side, even though you were going through it, how much on the other side you were already. I mean, it just really blessed my heart to see that. And I'm glad you're here. Amen. 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 Y'all should have responded better than that. So let me do it again. I'm glad you're here. Amen. Amen. That was better. Let's make our time nice today.
Phillip's kind of scanning the crowd for 18-year-old guys real quick. Yeah. That's a great testimony, Phillip. I love you, bro. Yeah.
Well, what do you do after that? Praise the Lord. Amen. God is good to us. Amen. And he always does exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. And he just has avenues of getting things to us that we don't even anticipate, that we don't even look at. One of the things that went with that story, Pastor, is that I was out with Darren and Regina, and we were sitting at Charleston's, and I was kind of being fussy. I know none of you have ever been like that, but I was being fussy just because, you know, I had to get to camp and things were going on with the car, and I was really just complaining. And Darren looks at me and he says, "Phillip, God's got a whole fleet of Cadillacs for you. You're doing his business. He's got a whole fleet, so don't be concerned about this one." And when he said that, it was like the light came on. Like, you know, I'm not doing this on my own. I'm not doing this just for myself. I'm doing this for the kingdom. And God has more than enough of everything. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. And so when I got the truck, praise the Lord, brother is, I mean, it's black on black now. We're getting along good. Instead of being black on black crime, it's black on black blessing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Well, I'm going to sing to you some today, and I'm going to exhort you some, and then sing to you some more, and exhort some more, and probably sing some more, and we're going to make it through this. Praise the Lord. I'm not going to be long today, just like Elizabeth Taylor told her eighth husband, I'm not going to keep you long. Amen. Amen. But some of y'all counting, yeah, I've done that two or three times myself, but anyhow, this is church, amen, and the church is about joy, amen. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and say a little bit better than that, joy in the Holy Ghost. Amen. So the Holy Ghost going to help you be happy today. Amen. The Holy Ghost is going to be better than pet milk to you today. I remember when I was a kid growing up, one of the commercials, they had a kid on there, and he would say, "Pet milk, it make me happy." Pastor, you're probably old enough to remember that. YouTube it. Amen. But Jesus makes us happier than pet milk. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We got a lot to celebrate today. Amen. So let's celebrate the goodness of God in this place. Start it over one more time if you can. There we go.
Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. Oh, I'm gonna praise his name. Each day he's just the same. Come help me praise him. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just. Oh, I'm gonna praise his name. Each day he's just the same. Thank you, sister. Come help me praise him. Has done. Well, I've got it. I've got it. I've got it. I've got it. Well, there's just something about that Holy Ghost. I can't explain it, but I've got it. I've got it. I've got it. Anybody full of joy this morning? Got it. I've got it. Well, there's just something about that Holy Ghost. I can't explain it, but I got it in my hands. I got it in my feet. I got it in my walk. I got it in my talk. I got it. Hey, God's not dead. Church, God's not dead. God's not dead. I can feel him in my hands. Feel him in my walk. Feel him in my talk. Feel him all over me. Oh, God's not dead. Our God's not dead. God's not dead. I can feel him in my hands. Feel him in my walk. Feel him in my talk. Feel him all over me. Oh, well, I've got it. Yeah, 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 I've got it. Well, there's just something about that Holy Ghost. I can't explain it, but I got it in my feet. Got it in my walk. Got it in my hands. Got it in my feet. Got it in my walk. Got it in my talk. Got it all over me. Hey. Come on, y'all. Help me this morning. Well, look what the Lord has done. You say it. Come on. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He when? I gotta praise his name. Oh, yeah. Look what the Lord. Come on, let's do it one more time this morning. Look, look what the Lord. Hey. What did he do, y'all? What else? What else? When? Woo! I gotta praise his name. Oh, yeah. Look what the Lord. Hey. I said, come help me praise him. Look what the Lord. Come help me praise him. Look what the Lord has done. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Well, somebody shout glory one good time. I said, shout it one good time. Y'all don't hear it like I hear it up here. So I just need to demonstrate it to you. I mean, it's just kind of like, glory, glory, glory. I need a man-sized glory. Yeah, that's what we need, but let's do it together. One, two, three. Yeah, there you go. Hallelujah. You can take your seats this morning, or you can run the aisle if you want to. It's run the aisle day. Amen. Just like Walmart runs a special. Sometimes we run a special at the church, and we just have a run the aisle special. Amen today. Amen. Get your blessing. Hallelujah. Nobody else gets theirs. You get yours. Amen. This is take it for yourself day. Hallelujah. If you want it,
like the woman with the issue of blood, reach out and get what you want. Amen. Don't get with the crowd. Get what you came for. Hallelujah. And sometimes getting what you came for means that you got to do stuff that everybody else is not willing to do. Some of y'all are still nervous. Okay, let me help you out. Hallelujah. That's how you go get yours. Amen. Is it necessary? Yeah, it's necessary. Mark Hankins says his dad said it's only necessary when it's necessary. Amen. Sometimes it's just necessary to get your praise out. Well, praise the Lord. Amen. Sometimes it's just necessary to give thanks to the Lord. Sometimes it's just necessary to praise God till the walls just fall in your life. Amen. Amen. Doesn't matter how anybody else feels about it. It's what you need from God. Hallelujah. So if you need a good dose of Holy Ghost joy this morning, just ha, 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 ha. Amen. Don't pay any attention to the people you got to go home with. Amen. If you get drunk in the Holy Ghost, amen, they'll look better to you. Some of y'all need to do a whole lot of ha-haing before you get out of here. Amen. Praise the Lord. Some of y'all looking like, Pastor, seriously, you got him up in here? Yeah, I'm the right one, baby. I am the right one. Amen. God sent me here for you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. How many of you are glad today to be born again? Washed in the blood of the Lamb, knowing that your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. Amen. Hallelujah. That Jesus has prepared a place for you. And that one day he's coming again and to receive us unto himself. Amen. He paid the price because he believed that we were worthy. Maybe no one else has spoke blessing over your life. Maybe no one else has spoke increase over your life. Maybe no one else has made provision for you. But God, through Jesus Christ, has made provision for you today. And he thought you were worthy. Hallelujah, Jesus. You thought I was worth saving. So you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping. So you clean me up inside. You thought I was to die for. So you sacrificed your life so I could be free, so I could be whole, so I could tell everyone I know. You thought I was worth saving. Woo. So you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping. So you clean me up inside. You thought I was to die for. Hey. So you sacrificed your life so I could be free, so I could be whole, so I could tell everyone I know. Oh, you thought I was worth saving. So you came. Hey, you thought I was worth keeping. So you clean me up inside. Oh, you thought I was to die for. So you sacrificed your life so I could be free, so I could be whole, so I could tell everyone I know. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to the God who changed my life. And I will worship. I'll praise you. Give you glory, Lord. Magnify your name.
Because I am free, because I am whole, and I will tell everyone I know.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. To the God who changed my life. Oh, and I will bless you. I'll worship you. Give you glory, Lord, for you made me whole. You changed my life. Made me a new creature in Christ. I magnify you. Glorify your name. Because I am free. Because I am whole. And I will tell everyone I know. You came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping. You cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for. You thought I was to die for. You thought I was to die for. Hey. Oh, so I can be free. Hallelujah, Jesus. He thought you were to die for. Hallelujah. Now you're free. Now you're whole. Hallelujah. Now you have a testimony that you can tell everyone that you know. Christ thought you were worth saving. You were worth it. You were worth it. You were worth it. Amen. Don't give up your hope. Hallelujah. Don't cast away your confidence. Hallelujah. I know that we're in a battle. Glory to God. The word of God says that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. Come on, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. But thank God, through Jesus Christ, we're already triumphant. We're already victorious. Already. Amen. Just because we get into a battle, amen, doesn't mean that we're not qualified to fight that battle. Jesus has already qualified you. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord Jesus. Amen. I love the scripture where Jesus said that I've come that your joy may be full. And many times we use that scripture only in the good times. Hello. But our joy can be full in adversity. Just because you're going through an adverse time, troubled time, doesn't mean that you have to get down in the mully grubs. Come on, somebody. Hello, just because there's difficulties at home doesn't mean that you have to get down and depressed and sad about it. Jesus gave us this thing called joy. Amen. If we will activate our joy that's on the inside of us, you'll find out that you'll come out a whole lot faster. Amen. Than you do staying in the depression. Amen. Jesus wants us full of joy all the time. All the time. He wants you happy all the time. Amen. Again, no matter what the test, no matter what you're going through, you can be happy. Come on, you all remember the secular song that said, don't worry, be happy. Amen. Make the choice to be happy. Praise the Lord. You may be going through some things today, amen, you may be facing some difficulties today, but I am a firm believer in this, is that your praise ought to match your miracle. Whatever you believe in God for, amen, your praise ought to match that. If you believe in God for healing in your body today, amen, your praise ought to match the degree of healing that you need in your body. Amen. If you're believing God for financial breakthrough in some areas in your life today, your praise ought to match that. Oh, I'm going to get some help in here in a minute.
Amen. Because I know there are some people in here today that are believing God for some things, and you're wondering how you're going to get to the other side of it. Your answer today is your praise. Amen. Just get your praise on. Get your hallelujah on. Get your glory to God on. Get your thank you, Jesus, on. Hallelujah. Because I'm not believing man to do it for me. I'm believing God to do this thing for me. Amen. Because he is able, like I said earlier, to do exceedingly above. I'm telling you, when I got that truck last year, I wasn't believing for a truck. Hello? I was believing for a vehicle that would be a blessing to me to get me across the country and all that, but a truck? Amen. I got a little bit more cityfied in me than that. You know, I take a Lexus or something like that, but, you know. You know, I don't think you look at me and think, well, that's a country boy, you know. But I'm telling you, when I got inside that truck and I got behind the wheel, it, like, yeah, thank you, sister. Like, this like putting on, you know, alligator shoes. Woo, Lord, I ain't got no alligators on today. But, you know, it just suited me. You know, and I was like, well, this is nice. And I was up high, you know, and it's like, I like this. And I drove it. And when I put my foot, you know, yeah, the pedal to the metal, baby, that thing has some power. I mean, it'll lay you back in the seat. You catch the Holy Ghost riding in there. Hey, thank you. Every time, hey, yay, Lord. Come on, somebody. Ah, praise the Lord. I need to put some of y'all in that truck and just help you catch the Holy Ghost. Why? Because that truck has some power. Amen. And there's Holy Ghost power on the inside of you that just want to lay you back in life. Amen. Hallelujah. There's so much God in you that you just have to decrease the power a little bit because you don't know how to handle. Hello. Amen. When I hit that accelerator, them wheels will peel on that truck. I don't do that too much though because them tires, you know, I had to pay the bill. So, but that power is available when I need it. Huh? When I need to get on the main interstate there off the ramp exit, when I need that power, it's there. And all I have to do is just step on it and it goes. Resident in you is the power of God. Let me come down here a little bit. Resident in you is the power of God and all the power that you need to overcome whatever it is that you're facing. The power is in you. Christ in you, the hope of glory. He is in you. Amen. And he's causing you to conquer whatever it is that's standing up in your face talking trash to you. Whoo! And how many of you know there are things in life? I'm sorry, I'm just kind of a common person. But how many of you know that there are things in life that just try to talk trash? I remember being in school and we had people in school that we called trash talkers. Huh? They always trying to talk up something. Always talking trash. Talking about how bad they are. What they going to do to you. They talk trash until somebody knew how to talk more trash than they knew how to talk. Many times we go through things because we don't talk back. Yeah. Thank you, brother. Give me a good amen. Amen. Help your brothers and sisters out. You know, I think they're still a little bit nervous about me being black, you know, and so be an example. Let them know it's all right. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. I hope you all are okay this morning. I'm a missionary to the white churches. You need help, baby. You need help. Woo. Thank you, sister. I got one black mama in the audience. Amen. Praise the Lord, preacher. Amen. Amen. To get those rivers, to get that river of life flowing on the inside of you. Amen. Because that's where your victory is. It's on the inside of you, and the more you activate it, and the more you flow with the rivers of life, rivers of joy that are on the inside of you, the more victory you're going to have in your life. And I'm telling you, life can get so good that you almost have to pinch yourself and say, oh my God, whoo, can it get any better? And on the inside, it's like, yeah, it can get better than this. Ain't got no Murphy's Law working for me. God's law. Yeah. Ha! It's working for me. He that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above, he'll exceed what you're believing for. He'll exceed it. Some of y'all gonna get happy in a minute. Yeah. Woo! He will exceed what you're believing for. Amen. He'll do more than what you ask. Amen, because he knows what you need, and he knows what you like. More than enough. Hallelujah. I was just been preaching a whole lot this past year on the subject of, devil, you can't have my stuff. Because the word of God says in John 10:10 that the thief comes, come on, to steal, kill, and destroy. He comes to subtract from my life. But Jesus came so that we have life. I like how it says it in the Amplified, in abundance, to the full, to the overflow. I like how God talks. God never ends with just enough. He always ends in overflow. But I've been preaching a whole lot just about how the enemy has come and he has robbed so many people of the best blessings and of the benefits that we have in Christ Jesus. And one of the reasons why he's been able to rob so many people is because there's not a fight back in believers. And so I've been going along stirring the fight back in people, just stirring that up, because when the enemy comes, you're not just supposed to tolerate his stuff. You're supposed to get him off your property. Amen. He's trespassing when he brings sickness. He's trespassing when he brings disease. He's trespassing when he brings depression and oppression. Come on, somebody. He's trespassing, and you need to get him off of your property. Amen. And not tolerate his trash talking. Amen. Hallelujah. You need to out-talk that rascal. Amen. I was brought up in a household where mama had the last word. Hello? My mama always got the last word because it was her house. It was four of us kids and my dad, but mama always had the last word. Y'all give me a better amen than that, mamas. Amen. No matter how much we... Yeah, thank you, brother. They need a little light. I'm getting lost in the darkness. Heard a voice, but I saw no one. Some of y'all going to get this in a minute. But she always got the last word because that was her domain. Even though we were her kids and we were the family, we didn't have the last say-so in her house. She had the last say-so. She had the last word, and she made sure she took full advantage of having the last word. Now, she didn't have all the power in the house because my dad was there, and sometimes me and my brother, because, you know, we're men and we're stronger than her, you know, we thought we could talk back a little bit. Huh? But then she say, honey, they talking back to me. And power would show up. I mean, she had power that backed her words. We thought we were safe because Daddy wasn't home, but when he got home and he heard how we were talking, all of a sudden the power showed up. Yay. He's like, you messing with my wife now. I don't care if she is your mama. She's my wife first. I know how to make more of you. And he make you scared, you know. So when the opportunity came again to talk back, you realize, yeah, Daddy didn't put the law down, and you better not talk back. Some of you just need to put the law down and let the Holy Ghost go to work on your benefit, and you'll find out that a whole lot of things that have been a repeat in your life will stop repeating. That was better than your amen. Some of y'all been living on repeat. Huh? Pete and Repeat were sitting on the fence. Pete fell off, and who was left? Pete and Repeat, huh? go on and on. But the Holy Ghost is there to help you. He's there to empower you to overcome. Not keep going back through the same cycle, but he's there for you to overcome that station in life. To go beyond that where you don't live in the repeat of disaster. You don't live in the repeat of sickness. You don't live in the repeat, come on, of poverty. You're not supposed to keep repeating that stuff. You're supposed to get beyond it. Come on now. Go up to another level. Anybody ever heard the expression, new level, new devil? It's true. There's adversity on every level that you go to, but you're equipped to go to that other level. One of the stories that I love to tell, and then I'm going to sing. Have I gone long enough? I said I'm going to be like Elizabeth Taylor. I ain't keeping you long. I got to be a man of my word. But last summer, I was outside cleaning up the Cadillac for the trip out this way. And I was washing it, cleaning it out and everything. And some of the neighbor kids were out playing basketball. And one of the older kids was playing the younger kid. And I mean, he was wearing him out. And he was talking trash to him. Hey, come on in here, boy. I'm not a basketball player. I'm a black person that can't do sports. But I can sing, okay? Praise the Lord. But, you know, the older one is talking trash to this little guy, and he's just shooting on him and scoring on him and, you know, just really beating him down verbally and taking it to him with the hoops. And all of a sudden, the young man's grandfather walked out on the porch. It was a high porch. And I, you know, was cleaning the car, but I was paying attention. Help me out, ladies. I was cleaning, but I was paying attention. And the grandfather, he stood out there and he watched for a few minutes. Just watched the game. And then all of a sudden, I heard his voice. And grandfather said, you can take him. You can take him. He don't have anything he don't have any advantage over you. All he is inside your head. And the boy kind of looked at his granddaddy like, you see this dude? He's big. He's bigger than me. But the grandfather said, you can take him. You can take him. And so the boy got a little bit more aggressive in his plan. And he got on the guy. And his grandfather started screaming, that's it. That's it. Get on him. Get on him. Don't let him just do what he wants to do. Get on him. Get on him. And the guy went pushing. He said, get back on him. Don't let him do you like that. Get on him. I pulled the microphone down so I wouldn't hurt your ears. Then he's like, get on him, get on him. And when he got on him and he put pressure on him, all of a sudden this older guy wasn't able to dribble. He couldn't handle the ball like he could without the pressure. He couldn't make the shot because that little guy was putting pressure on him. Huh? That little guy had more energy. And all of a sudden, that little guy found his help. And he started listening to his granddaddy, and his granddaddy was telling him what to do. And the next thing you know, that little boy scored. And I mean, when he scored, he threw a party. He got so excited because he scored against something that had been talking trash to him. Somebody that had been scoring on him and somebody that made him feel like he was less. Now, all of a sudden, he's scoring. But he's scoring not because of his own strength and own ability, but because he listened to what his granddaddy was telling him. And his granddaddy was telling him, this is how you win. This is how you shut him down. This is how you do it. And the guy that was trying to shut the little guy down, he got so upset, he looked up at the granddaddy and said, shut up, go back in the house. And then he looked at him and said, you come down here. You come on down here. And the granddaddy looked at him and said, you don't want me down there. You don't want me down there because I know how to play you. He said, I might be old, but I know how to play you. I know your game. I know your game. He said, I'll smack your stuff over in the bushes. Amen. The Holy Ghost inside of you knows the devil's game. And he's trying to help you and teach you, amen, to win in life, to be more than a conqueror. Amen. To shut the devil's mess down. Just hallelujah. Shut it down. Hallelujah. Whoo! Where you don't keep living again in the same cycle. Some of y'all got a 2-week cycle. 30-day cycle. 6-month cycle. Well, 6 months, about time for Brother Bill to call. He'll smile at me real big, and I won't know that I'm talking about you. It's the same cycle. God wants to break you out of your cycles and break you into territory that you've never experienced before. Bring you into victory that you've never experienced before. We are more than conquerors through him. Amen. He has made us the head and not the tail. He has made us above and not beneath. You all know there's a lot going on in our nation right now. I'm going to wrap it up. I promise. I'm going to wrap it up. A lot going on in our nation right now. And the enemy is really trying to make it look like that we are a divided nation. Y'all listening to me? He's trying to take a few and make it look like the mass. And so we just need to be who we're called to be. I wish I could take a picture today and just show everybody on Facebook that we can get along with each other, that a black man can come in and preach to a predominantly white congregation. Hello. And we can all get along. I need a better amen in that.
Amen.
Yeah, well, you got a deep voice. What's wrong with you? I ain't heard you all day. He's shy. Ain't nothing shy about you. Get over yourself. You stay around me, you won't be shy. Shy. Anyhow, we can all get along. But there's stuff that we need to let go of so that we can get along. Amen. Hello? Amen. I'm going to mess with it just a little bit, and then I'm going to sing. But being brought up in a predominantly black area, predominantly black neighborhood, hello, there are certain things that you're taught. And I'm a child of the 60s, and so there was a lot of racial issues going on in our country at that time. Some of y'all remember? Amen. Praise the Lord. A lot going on. And one of the things that was happening during that time was the integration of schools. And my mama decided, I love preaching about my mama because of all the stuff she did to us. All the stuff she put us through, she's getting payback now. But it was good. But she decided that she was not going to take us across town to go to school. There was a school in our neighborhood. It was an all-white neighborhood, and integration had you know, the law or whatever had been passed. And she said, you all are going right over here to the school, just a couple of blocks from the house. Amen. And she took us over there and enrolled us. Huh? Glory. And here we are, these black kids in this all white school. Good. Well, you say that. But there were things to break through. There were barriers that had to be dealt with, and being in, brought up in a black community, one of the words that you fight about is when somebody uses the N-word. You all with me? And so it's just like on the inside of you. Somebody says that, you know, you're supposed to punch them in the mouth. You ain't supposed to let nobody get by with calling you that. And so that's put in you. You fight that, you know. Don't let nobody talk to you like that. Real quiet in the church this morning. We're going to be all right. I mean, it gets better. But when I begin to learn the word of God and find out that I'm not a black man, but I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus, that old things are now passed away, and behold, all things are become brand new. When the word of God says all things are become brand new, he meant all. So that meant my way of having a black mentality had to be done away with. Huh? That meant I had to renew my mind to where the N-word didn't bother me anymore, because that's not my title. That's not my handle. That's not who I am. Huh? So when somebody calls me that, it's like somebody calling me Walter. Hey, Walter. 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 You can scream Walter at me. That's not my name. You're not going to bother me, because that's not my name. I'm not identified with Walter. My name is Phillip. If you want Phillip, you need to call Phillip. Or you can call me whatever you want to, but unless you call Phillip, you don't get my attention. Amen. Some of y'all gonna get that later on today. A folk calling you stuff and you're responding, and it's not what you are. It's not who you are. Amen. How many of you know the devil will put you to the test? Yeah. Woo! So I go to a church to do a revival. And the pastor and I, he invites me to go to the door at the beginning of the service to greet the people as they're coming in. Who does that? Anyhow, so we're greeting the people as they come in. And a lady walks up to him, and she just is jubilant and joyful, and she goes, "Hey, Pastor, I didn't know we were having a here to preach. Yeah, we hadn't even had the first service yet. Oh. Like, no, she didn't. All of a sudden, you know, I thought I'd been renewed and it didn't bother me anymore, huh? But all of a sudden, here it is in the brother's face." So what do you do? Oh, that's what my flesh said. But I was the only black person there, and I knew I couldn't win. So I don't know why I did this, but I reached out and I grabbed her. And I hugged her, and I caught her in this position. And she was like that. And I looked at her in the eyes, and I said, "Before this week is out, you and I, we're going to be best friends." That had to be the Holy Ghost. That was not in my mind. That was not what I was thinking. You know, Holy Ghost hadn't told me nothing ahead of time. Whew. And so I let her go, and she goes, as if to say, "It touched me." And I wanted to hit her in the back of her head so bad. Sorry. But I am, had to deal with that flesh. But anyway, we had a Holy Ghost blowout that week. And I mean, the Holy Ghost fell on us. And every chance I got, I ran over and I laid hands on that woman. wasn't God. I just laid hands on her. Sometimes it was God, sometimes it wasn't. And I just say, bless her. Bless her, Jesus. Bless her. Bless her. Ooh, bless her, Jesus. Bless her, bless her, bless her. Bless her, bless her. Bless her. Bless her. Bless her, bless her. Like I say, sometimes it was God, sometimes it was just me. But I'm telling you, by the time we got to the end of the week, she walked up to me and she put her arms around me and she said, I just love you. She didn't apologize, come to think of it, but but she put her arms around me and she said, I just love you. And she said, the next time that you come, she said, I want you to stay at my house. I said, oh no, I ain't doing that. I said, you've been in this meeting all week long and God's had a chance to deal with you and work on your heart. I said, but you got family, they hadn't been here. No, ma'am, I appreciate the invitation, but it ain't going down like that. Brother smarter than that. Amen. Jesus came so that your joy could be full. Jesus came so that we could have life in abundance to the full, to the overflow. And there is no greater joy than knowing that people can't affect you by labels that they give you. Somebody can't steal my joy because they call me something. I'm going to say that one again. People can't steal my joy just because they call me something. Some of y'all got to go home this evening and deal with some stuff. So I'm going to say it again. People can't steal my joy just because they call me something. Amen. Maybe I need to say it one more time because I know you dealing with Henry. And Henry got a nasty mouth. Hopefully nobody's named Henry in here this morning. And Henry just talks trash to you and makes you feel like you're nothing. But Henry can't steal what's on the inside of you. Amen. That's not your label. That's right. That's not who you are. Amen. Amen. The greater one lives on you, on the inside of you, and has made you more than a conqueror. I keep going over this morning, and there needs to be some fight back. Yes, right. On the inside of you. There needs to be some fight back where you just don't lay down and just take it. You're not laid down to just take it. You're not designed to just lay down and take it. Amen. I was talking to Pastor Tom, and we're going to do that song, all right? Even if I keep talking, I'm going to tell this right quick. And if I keep talking, just play the song. But I was talking with Pastor Tom, and we were talking about just the situation that you're going through. And I told him toward the end of our conversation, I said, well, now you got Goliath's head to walk around with. You had to face the giant. And you know you have to face the giant, you're supposed to walk around with his head. Come on, somebody. You're supposed to have a testimony of I got his head. I got his big head right here. I got his big head. Amen. You're made more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. It doesn't matter your size. It doesn't matter the size of your giant. It matters the size of the God on the inside of you. And the God on the inside of you is greater than all. Amen. This means war. We already won. Come on, y'all stand up. Oh! Hey! I got joy in my soul. God is in control. Satan's on my trail. But I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. Hey, say, this means war. I'm not backing down, no.
This means war. This means war, say, yeah. This means war. Come on. Woo. I got joy in my soul. God is in control. Satan's on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. Hey, somebody say this means war. Oh, we're not backing down, no. This means war. This means war, say.
This means.
The blood of Jesus, I plead.
I plead the
blood. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. Hey, we're more than conquerors through the blood.
I plead Woo! The blood.
Hey, I've been in the storm and the rain, but the blood still stays the same. Whatever's going on, my war clothes are on. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. Hey, this means war. Say,
this means war.
Oh, this means war. Say,
this means war.
Oh, this means war. This means war. We're not backing down, no. This means war. Here we go. Hey, you can't have my family. You can't have my increase. You can't have my breakthrough. Oh, you can't have my, you can't have my, you can't have my. I plead, the blood of Jesus covers you today. Hey, thank God for the blood of Jesus. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb, yeah. I plead the blood of Jesus. Oh, come on, put your hands together. Hey, say, this means war. Say, this means war. We're not backing down, no. This means war. We're taking our ground, say. Oh, we're moving up higher. This means war. Glory, thanks be to God who always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. God bless you today. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Come on up here, Phillip. Praise the Lord. Walter, come on up. Come on, let's have a seat real quick, all right? How many of y'all enjoyed that today? Did you enjoy that today? What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing. It's good to have, the Bible says in Proverbs 17:22, the merry heart does good like a medicine,
Amen.
But a broken spirit dries the bones. And so it's just good. He that has a merry heart has a continual feast.
Amen.
And so that illustration that you gave about when people say things, if that's not, it, just don't let it get you going, Phillip. That's just a great, that's a great illustration.
Amen.
All right, here we go. This song is for somebody here today, so just receive it.
What he said he would do. He will stand by his word. He will come through, church. God will do everything, everything he said he'd do. He'll stand by his word. He will come through. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. No way, no how. Oh, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. That God will do what he said he would do. He will stand by his word. He will come through, church. God, hey, he's faithful to his word. He'll stand by his word, yeah. He will. So I won't be of the arrows by day from the hands of my enemies. I can stand my ground with the Lord on my side, for the snares they have set will not succeed. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. Hey, no weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. Woo! I know God will do everything he said he would do. He will stand by his word. He stand by his word. He will come through. No weapon formed against me. Oh, it won't work. Hey, no weapon. Woo! Against me. It won't prosper. No way, no how. Listen, don't be afraid of the snare or the arrow sent by your enemy, cause it ain't gonna work, no. Doo-doo. Listen, you may be lied on, cheated, talked about, mistreated, but no weapon formed against you is gonna prosper, no. Even if you lose your job, you can't pay your bills. No weapon formed against you is gonna prosper. In Christ, we always win. Hallelujah. God bless you.
All right. Well, you know, Pastor's putting in more requests as we go along, you know. You know what I'd love to do, Phillip?
Yes, sir.
A missionary to the white churches. Come on up here if you would. We have our missionaries here. We always give them a good hug and tell them we love them.
Amen.
And I want us on to, you know, I don't know, if you enjoyed this service, I think we ought to just on our way out, if you want to just come by, shake his hand, tell him you love him. And tell him to come back to UConn soon. How many believe that? Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. We love you, brother. We bless you in the name of Jesus. We thank you for Phillip Slaughter. We thank you, Lord, for the anointing on his life, Lord. Use him in Arkansas this week as he ministers to the youth there. Father, we believe that, Father, that you'll use him to leave an impact on the next generation, Father. In Jesus' precious name, And everyone said amen. Amen. All right, just stand up if you would. If you'd like to come up and just shake a hand or hug a neck and tell him you love him, we'd love for you to do that. So we love you, Phillip. Praise God. Regina's going to take us out today with some good worship.